Hello, and welcome to your new Drupal website basic training. In today's segment, we're going to cover how to create a new basic page for your website. As always, first things first, you're going to want to log into the website so you have access to the toolbars. And the next thing you're going to want to do is click Add Content. This will take you to a list of the content that you can add. And for this example, we're going to go ahead and choose basic page. Once the basic page templates loads up, what you're going to see is a bunch of fields and dropdowns and things like that where you can add information. So first things first, title, pretty self-explanatory there. Go ahead and enter whatever title you'd like the page to have. And the next thing we'll want to do is add an image. Now this image is going to reside at the top of your page. It's something we call like a hero or a banner image. So it kind of sets the tone for the page and the content that it's about to deliver below the image. In order to upload something there, go ahead and select Choose File. And then you can choose from images anywhere on your computer. In this case, we're going to select this here. And then we're going to click Upload. My image was too large for the dimensions, so it's been resized to fit. That's totally fine. The alternate text and title can be added if you desire. They are for accessibility and some SEO purposes, so that's up to you if you think you'll need those. And after you've got the image, we'll move down to the body field. Now this is where you'll do most of the editing and adding of the information to the page. So there's some buttons in here that'll be a little unique to the Drupal process, but in most cases, as you can probably already see, a lot of these are already tools that you're familiar with if you've used a word processing program. So to start with some of the ones that are not so familiar, we'll go over those and show you how to add a couple of things to the basic page. To start, we'll want to probably have some text on our page. So let's take some text here and copy that. And now we're going to try to add it. Now, if you're copying and pasting from other sources, you probably don't want to just copy and paste like this, because what can happen is you can pick up styles or tags or pieces of code from wherever your source is. Now in this case, it's not very likely because I'm coming off of just a regular document. But if you were copying and pasting from another website, or maybe not just a regular document or something like that, then you may bring over some of those styles. So to prevent that from happening, what you want to do is you want to use one of these three paste tools that we have here. So we have paste as plain text, paste from Word, and just paste. The rule of thumb that I use for this is if you're going to use Word, go ahead and paste from Word. If you're pasting from anywhere else, use paste as plain text. So in this case, we'll hit paste as plain text, put our text in there, and it puts it in. As you can see, it's a little bit larger than when we added it because it's taken all the formats and the styles off of it. And once your text is in there, you can click in and use your normal editing tools just like you would on Word or some other text editing program like that to make changes to the content. Now that you have some text in the body, you'll probably want to add an image or two in addition to the image that we have at the top. In order to do that, what you want to do is click this button here. Looks like two little mountains with the moon or sun over the top of them, and that's our image upload button. Go ahead and click that. This will bring up the image properties window. And the first thing you want to do is get an image to put in here. So you'll want to click Browse Server. This is going to open up an additional window that will enable you to upload your image file to the server. The first thing you want to do is click Upload and then Choose File. This will bring up your regular desktop browser, and you can select the image that you're after and hit choose. Then go ahead and click upload. Once it's been uploaded, you'll see it in the list. To select it, you can do one of two things. You can simply double click on it here, or you can click insert file. And once you've selected your file, you'll see the new URL from the server showing up in the box here, which tells the website where to reference to find the image. And once you've got that in there, there's a couple of other fields. You can add alternate text right here if you wanted to have some alt text for SEO or accessibility. You can also, if not done previously, adjust the height or the width of your image accordingly. So they can be adjusted together or independently by clicking this. That will allow them to be adjusted just the height or the width, or if you click this, they should adjust as the same. Border is just what it sounds like. It will add a little border to your image, as you can kind of see here. If we go down to 1, it's a smaller black line, 10, a larger one, and then 100 is a pretty good size border. HSpace and VSpace are for when you have text bumping into your image or getting a little close. VSpace is vertical space, so if we wanted to put some space here in between the text and the image, we can put 10 in there, which will give us a nice little buffer, or just like before, 100, which will give us quite the gap in there. HSpace is the same thing, it's just for horizontal. The last thing on here is alignment. It's going to be not set by default, and then you can choose left or right. And what this does is, if you have text that's going and you're putting the image in the middle of it, this will tell the text to wrap around the left or the right. By default, it'll just be not set, which just means the image is going to live wherever you put it. So once you've got all of that set up, go ahead and click OK. And then we should see our image with all of the settings that we applied to it here in the body field. So there's our text and there's our image. One of the other things that you'll commonly do here in this field is create a link, or a link to a page on your site or an external website. And to do that, you'll want to put in the text that you want the link to say. So we'll do a test link internal and a test link external. Now, once you've got the text and what you want your button to say, click to highlight it, and then we're going to choose this little link button, which should look like two little chain links. Once you click that, then it'll bring up this window, and you can enter in your URL. So for an internal link, you only have to use what's called the relative URL, which is basically just what comes after the .com or .net or whatever. So if you wanted to go to your contact page, it's usually going to be, you know, yourdomain.com/contact. So all that we actually need is the /contact portion of that. The protocol will switch to other, indicating it's an internal link, and then you can go ahead and hit OK. And then we should see the color change and the underline indicating that this is a link. The next one here is our test link external. So again, click to highlight, click the link button, and this time you'll want to put the full URL of the site you're trying to access. And because it's an external site, you probably don't want to have someone navigate away from your site completely to get this additional information. So what you want to do is click target, and then we're going to set this up to open in a new window. Most browsers will have this open in a new tab rather than a new window, so that way they can see the information you're trying to link to them in a new tab while not being navigated away from your website. So we click OK there, and then we have our test link showing up as well. So now we've got a couple links, some basic text, and an image here with a border and some other stuff. And once you've got everything entered in the body field, you'll want to scroll down below that. And the first thing you'll run into is the tag section. This is something we have set up for grouping of content into like views and things that are easily accessible. So if you don't have something specific to put here, a good rule of thumb is just to use your page title. In this case, it's just title. So we'll go ahead and enter that here. Once you've got that, then you can move on to this very bottom section, and we'll go over the boxes here. The first that you'll see is this meta information, which is meta keywords and meta description and the copyright. These are for SEO and search results and that type of thing. Basically, you'll probably want to have something in here, or if you have a company or someone who does SEO and marketing for you, then they will be able to either enter these or provide you with what should go in there. The next box is our menu settings box. So if you want this page to be on your new main menu, you can check the box here and you can edit the link title if you'd like it to be something other than the page title. And then you'll choose the parent item where it's going to live. By default, it's going to be the main menu, but if you'd like to have it live under something like about, then you select that as the parent item and then it will show up under about. In this case, we're just going to put it on the main menu. The menu link attributes, you do not need to use those. There's nothing in there that's going to affect what you're doing. XML sitemap, also not something you'll need to worry about. URL path aliases, probably won't need to worry about that. But if you want to take a look at it and adjust it, the generated automatic URL alias is just going to be whatever your title is. So it'll be, you know, yourwebsite.com/title. But if you want it to be something other than that, you can uncheck the box and give it a specific thing to say on the relative URL. So once you've adjusted that, then you can go down in revision information. If you need to create a new revision, you can do that, and you can put the log message of the things that you changed. Authoring information is going to be whoever you are logged in as. If you want to change that, you'll have to put in a new user and have the name say what you want it to say. Authored on is the date, and as long as you follow the format listed here, then you can adjust that to show whatever you want. And then publishing options will allow us to publish the page or unpublish it, in which case it will not be displayed. So we're going to go ahead and leave ours published, and now we're going to save. And once you hit save, it'll take us out to the basic page. So this is our hero or banner image. These are the two links we created. This is the text we added and the other image that we added in the body. So now would be a good time to go ahead and test our links and see if they work. So this test link internal should take us to the contact page. So let's click on that and see where we go. All right, right on. Took us right to the content page. Go ahead and hit the back button and we'll test our external link. This one should take us to Google and it should open up in a new tab up here. There's google.com and there's our new tab. So it looks like the link is working and everything should be good. That's pretty much it for a basic page. So that will conclude this segment and today's training.